So I would like to share a few things that's been coming up lately, some new awareness. It's been super intense, over a month now with what's happening with social service, and they are not listening to me. And so in order to make myself heard, I started to look into other videos about the disease I have and other resources, which I rarely ever do. It's for some reason I haven't done that much or been in Facebook groups of this disease. And well, I am part of it, but I don't look at it much. And these things that are related to the disease that I have, I haven't been involved in things and read and in the beginning when I was sick many years ago, but not so much after that at all, actually. But now to, in an attempt to make them hear what I'm saying, if they can't hear what I say, maybe other people who talk about this, maybe they could listen in to them and hear what they're saying. That was my idea behind that. And then I had really this huge like realization and awareness about this, like, wow, I haven't looked at this much, and as soon as I do, it's really heavy, and I get that sort of one part of that is if you sort of go into the story more and look into that, you sort of just create more of that. So to have your focus more on what will change in it and what will create more ease is more, creates more healing and moving forward. But is that the whole truth? And it's like I was taught from the very beginning, from 20 years ago, when I started looking into alternative treatments to change this, that I was very intensely, it was made a wrongness to talk about the disease and to look at that. And also to ask for help about things that I had was difficult with regards to that. So everything that had to do with the disease was sort of almost made for, maybe not almost, it was made forbidden. And it was a lot of charge to that, and I really took that, deeply inside of me too, that it was a wrongness. I made that mind that it is a wrongness to talk about it, to look at it. And I should be ashamed of it, and I should take care of myself, and I should not ask for help because it's a wrongness that I'm sick, and asking for help then will just stick it even more, which is such a weird concept when I look at it right now. And there are two questions in Access Consciousness, two tools that I would like to bring up here to shed light on this. And first, this is a bit a different video from videos I've made before, because I always make a video when I'm full of energy, and that is a very little part of my time having this disease that is like that. It's a few minutes here and there, and now it's almost even difficult for me to talk, but I watching this amazing woman who made this documentary that I posted about. She totally shows that side, the really sick side, and how that looks, and without shame. And I'm very inspired by that, and to not hide that. So yes. So yes, so I wanted to just say that. questions, the access tools, are what's right about this I'm not getting, and what's the contribution in this? And if I'm just making this disease a wrongness, something I should overcome and then I should start living, and something that I'm not, well, that is one part, then I'm totally missing that. And also, like, if I'm not allowed to talk about it, or look at it, then I might also miss out on what's right about this and what is the contribution of this. And before I'm willing to receive that, you know, maybe I can't change it, because I might have created it for those reasons, for those, for whatever it is that it is contributing. So how insane it might even seem, that might have been my choice somewhere, sometime. And I just realized that through these weeks now, and that that it could be actually a contribution to others to share this story, and it could be inspiring in and it could help others with this disease, but also just doesn't have to be that, but just be inspiring to speak up and share things that are vulnerable, and share yourself just as you are just right now, and whatever else that I might have, like, that I might not even be able to imagine that it could contribute. And as long as I have that wrongness in place, like, it shouldn't be like this because it is stopping my life, and if this has changed, then I can't start living my life, then I miss that. And also the other part where I was taught that it was wrong to... And I think that it will be not straight. It will be... Okay, anyway. The picture will be a bit, maybe, leaning. Okay, anyway. So... Yeah, if I make it a wrongness to talk about it, then the contribution it could be to share this. And whatever is there that I can't even put words to yet, but I'm starting to sense, and starting to be able to access the outer sort of surface of it, because it's been so far from me because of this wrongness that I bought into about talking about this, and that the contribution should be afterwards and how I've healed, or, you know, interesting point of view that I have, that point of view, also brilliant access tool, but really this to... Yeah, I wanted to give that energy that I cannot yet put words to. And really, whatever is going on in your life, you're making a huge wrongness. What if you ask, what's the contribution in this? And what's right about this I'm not getting? What's the contribution of this? And it can be to yourself, but it can be also to others, or both. You know, it can be any sort of way. So, so if I can't yet outcreate this, how can I create together with this? And how can I bring in the contribution that this is into my life and to others who are ready and willing to receive whatever that could be? And I've spoken for 9 minutes. I can't, like... I was just gonna make a mini video about this, but maybe I've been repeating myself. Okay, so... Thank you for watching this. I'm really grateful for you seeing me exactly like this. Bye.